model. Soichi Noguchi and Steve Robinson in the very early state, where the ISS flight control team on duty at this hour consists of Flight Director Brian Lunny on the right side of your... Thank you.
spacewalking activities continue on board Discovery. They're about to begin some work for some localized inspection of the reinforced carbon-carbon surfaces on Discovery. Pilot Jim Kelly and mission specialist Charlie Camarda will be working the robotic arm of Discovery to put in instruments on the end of the orbit boom sensor system into position to look at one of the port wing reinforced carbon-carbon panels.
Vegas, we copy for the focused inspection, and if you can tell Eileen or someone else that we need to terminate the CWC fill now.
He's on it. Okay, Andy, I got the two wire ties in place. It's nice, not as long as before, but MLI is not covering the surface of GPS antenna.
Okay, so if you could just move body down towards your seat a little bit, we might get a better view of your wireless video to the ground.
1040.
Yeah, that looks very good, Sergi. Okay, you can place the old GPS antenna in the small U bag. Copy.
This is Mission Control Houston, back with video from the helmet camera on Soichi Noguchi as he is documenting the condition of samples in the detailed test objective box at the very back of the payload bay. Mike Massimino asked him to use a photogrammetry technique, which has him taking photos of the exact same subject from about 10 inches away, slightly different angles, so that they can be used to compare the pictures in a stereoscopic manner. Meanwhile, Steve Robinson stowing the materials and space experiment package inside the Quest airlock.
Thank you.
pretty calm.
Nebraska.
Nice work. Third,
Wisconsin and Minnesota.
And then, if you would, we'll close the lid of the DTO box, remove the two pit pins from the hinge, stow in the lid, and then close the lid.
Copy.
Logistics module holding tons of supplies and equipment for the International Space Station. system on its end for some very high fidelity inspections of the port wing leading edge of Discovery, looking at panels 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 with both the intensified television camera and the laser camera system on the end of that orbiter boom sensor system.
and the International Space Station move from southwest to northeast, about to cross the equator into an orbital sunrise. Work underway to reposition the space station's robotic arm, the Canadarm2, onto its normal base of operations on a grapple fixture on the Destiny laboratory.
Your plan for pushing FCMS off to Flight Day 7 should work out just fine, so we will make that change and we'll reflect it on the Flight Day 7 flight plan when it comes up.
Thanks, Steve, and thank you for the flexibility.
Discussion between Steve Frick, the spacecraft communicator here in the shuttle flight control room, and pilot Jim Kelly on board Discovery, dealing with delaying until the seventh day of the mission, 2 days from now, a checkout of the fuel cell monitoring system, essentially a self-check of the system that governs the operation of the three power-producing fuel cells aboard the orbiter. This is a experimental test objective, using new techniques to monitor the fuel cells during the course of a shuttle mission. Because the crew is quite busy on board, this activity will be deferred until Monday. No impact to the mission at all. inertia that Noguchi will be applying to the deliberately damaged tiles in the sample box at the rear of Discovery's cargo bay at the outset of today's spacewalk has very sensitive thermal characteristics.
Just give us a call when you do step one. We need to start a timer when the wireless video heater goes on.
Thank you.
system hatch and return inside the space shuttle. 6 hours, 21 minutes into this EVA so far. Scheduled to be 6.5 hours, so although it got off to a late start, about an hour late, it looks like they're going to be ending it at the end of the planned duration for the EVA.
Heaven is above.
Okay, you still yours?
There's something going on.
Hey, Andy, we just noticed something. We'd like to remind Shuichi to get the quarter turn fastener on the port safety tether stowage box there.
It's too late. Okay, we can take care of that. Shuichi, did you copy that? The quarter turn fast on the port stowage box is apparently loose.
And Andy, that's not a reminder. It's something that just we overlooked here. We need to get that done. We just saw it now.
We understand. Yep, that's it. Sorry, Chief. Secure now. That's taken care of, Mike. There's something going on.
Good.
and attach it to your waist pedal first. My mistake.
Yeah.
Okay, Steve, I want to release your 80,000 center now. I'm ready. Okay? And I use this as a long chain. Okay. And then I'm ready to release my 85 pound handrail. 0417. And you want me to be a steer rail before it gets there? Before it gets grounded?
Awesome views, great job, everything was just perfect, extra stuff got done. and we look forward to another two great EVAs and a great flight continuing. We're going to hand you over to the shuttle room, and we'll be talking to Julie.
Okay, Mike, thanks for your support. We appreciate it very much, and the efforts of Cindy, Matt, Allison, and Deb, and Rolf to make all this happen.
We appreciate all the nice words you have for us throughout the EVA. The whole team appreciates that as well. You guys get some rest, get inside safe, get some rest, and we'll talk to you soon.
You bet. Hey, man. And Sergi, could you get on your SCU once you're there?
Okay. I see the above car OFS position on the hatch.
Reports good ship's power for both spacewalker suits.
I'll get the cover off. Oh, yeah.
External hatch closed at 11:27 a.m., awaiting repressurization of the airlock.
Okay, O2 push